dummy speak. Why don't you speak?
Scared. Can't talk.
All right, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Come, get a hold of yourself. Come with me. Just take a deep breath. Let it out slowly.
I'm named Paul Bloom. I'm an accountant. I'm from Whitehall & Marks, and I've come here to do your books.
Oh, yeah. Well, listen. Who is it?
Me. Touch me.
Oh, may touch me. On my back is... Listen, I have to meet with an important investor. Do me a big favor. Go to the bathroom.
But I don't have to go.
Try. Think of Niagara Falls.
Be with you in a moment, my darling.
Hello, gorgeous.
Wound me, touch me,
Oh, darling, wait. I haven't even had coffee yet. Take it easy.
Oh, my God.
Send me to the moon, you animal.
Yes.
Send me to the moon.
Yes, my darling. Thursday. Come back Thursday. I'll send you to the moon Thursday. But first, the checky.
Where's the checky? Come on. Find the checky.
See you Thursday.
Ta-da! Ta-da! Bye!
May I come out of the bathroom now, Mr. Bialystock?
Yeah, sure.
I'm terribly sorry I caught you feeling up the old lady.
Feeling up the old lady? How dare you condemn me without knowing all the facts?
Oh, Mr. Bialystock, I wasn't condemned.
Shut up! I'm having a rhetorical conversation. Do you know who I used to be?
Yes. Yes, you are Max Bialystock, the King of Broadway.
No, I'm Max Bialystock. That's right.
And might I say, Mr. Bialystock, and please don't take this the wrong way, but you're not just a dirty old man.
Thank you.
Oh, you're also a great Broadway producer. And there's something about me you should know. I've had a secret desire to be a Broadway producer.
A secret desire? Okay. Can I give you a little advice?
Yes, sir.
Keep it a secret. Do the books, please. What is that, a handkerchief?
Oh, there's no, it's nothing, it's nothing.
Oh, well, if it's nothing, then why can't I see it?
My blanket! My blue blanket! Leave my white blue blanket! Ah! Give me my blanket! No!
Who's my little accountant? Are you my little accountant? Are you my little accountant?
I am, man.
Are you my little accountant?
I am.
Yes, you are.
Now, let's see. If we add up these deductions, we get... There's three, but no four, so take that. Amazing. It's absolutely amazing, but... Under the right circumstances, a producer could make more money with a flop than he could with a hit. This is quite possible. If he were certain that a show would fail, a man could make a fortune.
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yes, what you were saying. Keep talking.
What was I saying?
You were saying that under the right circumstances, a producer could make more money with a flop than he could with a hit.
Well, yes. When you produced your last show, Funny Boy, you raised $2,000 more than you needed. But you could have raised a million. Put on your $100,000 flop and kept the rest.
But what if my show was a hit?
Well, then you would go to jail. You see, rather than 100% of the show, you would have sold more than 1,000%. So if the show's a success, there's no way to pay off the backers. Get it?
Got it. So in order for our scheme to work, we have to find a surefire flop.
Our scheme? What scheme?
What scheme? Your scheme, you bloody little genius!
It's so simple.
Step one, we write the worst play ever written. Step two, we hire the worst director in town. Step three, I raise $2 million.
Two?
Yes, one for me, one for you.
There's a lot of little old ladies out there.
Step four, we hire the worst actors in New York and open on Broadway. And before you can say step five, we close on Broadway, take out $2 million, and go to Rio. We can do it. We can do it.
Repeat after me. I solemnly swear. Yeah. That was his middle name.
Enough, Elizabeth Nicola.
Good. Now I sign your contract.
Yes, here we are. Right here.
Okay, this is my associate, Mr. Bloom. We have an appointment with renowned theatrical director Roger Dupree.
Ah, yes. Yes, please come in. Please.
Thank you.
Yes. May I take your hat, your coat, and your swastikas?
Oh, please.
We're here. I need to tell you, you saw those. I didn't notice them. You held them to look straight ahead. You remember that? That's all right. That's not fine. Okay. Roger! We're not alone. Here's Roger!
Thanks. He's wearing the dress.
Okay. Listen, I know we sent it to you already this morning, but did you get a chance yet to read Springtime for the headline?
Read it? I devoured it. And I find it remarkable.
Remarkable! Then you'll do it!
Do it? Of course not. It's not my kind. Really?
Max, please. World War II?
Too dark. Too depressing. The theater's so obsessed. The drama's so depressing.
It's hard to sell a ticket on Broadway.
Shows should be more pretty. Shows should be more witty. Shows should be more... What's the word? Gay? Exactly. Keep it gay, keep it gay, keep it gay.
Couldn't agree more, and you have our blessings, Roger, to make Springtime for Hitler just as gay as anyone could possibly want.
Hey, sorry, Max, it's simply not my cup of tea. Still, fair is fair. Perhaps I should ask my production team what they think.
That is brilliant, brilliant, brilliant! I speak for Mr. Bloom and myself, Roger, when I say that you are the only man in the world who can do justice to Springtime.
This is a very big decision. It might affect the course of my entire life. I shall have to think about it.
Now
I'll do it.
Exclusive Broadway rights to the worst show ever written and a signed contract with the worst director who ever lived.
We're in business.
Come here, I want to show you something.
What do you see?
Nothing.
Exactly. But now that we've got our surefire flop, it's going to be our job to fill that safe with $2 million.
$2 million? Gee, how much do we put in?
How much do we put in?
Boom. The two cardinal rules of being a Broadway producer are one, never put your own money in the show.
And two,
never put your own money in the show!
Get it?
Got it. Good. So how do we raise the money?
How? I'll tell you how. From my investors. Hundreds of little old ladies, all looking to Max Bialystock for one last thrill on their way to the cemetery. So, in the days to come, Bloom, you shall see very little of me. And right now, I'd like to see very little of you. Scram while I get myself ready. For Max Bialystock is about to launch himself into little old lady land.
Have you ever heard the German band?
No.
That is the name of the song I am going to sing.
Oh.
Play it, please. Haben Sie gehört, das deutsche Band? Mit der Band, mit der Band, mit der Band, mit der Band. Oh, oh, oh.
Figurehead, that's what you buy. This is how you say, Common Figurehead, that's what you buy.
What did you say? I couldn't hear it.
What's the matter? All I said was good luck.
Yes. Has anyone ever told you it's bad luck to say good luck on early night?
What do I say? I think
what you say.
You can play Hitler. All right. All right. I'll do it. I'll do it. I've got to get in the makeup. Quick, it runs his Hitler mustache.
Relax. This is it.
It's not too late.
Your love began to fade. I'm crying in the hoosegow. You're in Rio getting laid.
Be straight.
He walked into my office with his cockamamie scheme. You can make more money with a flap under the head.
Speak to me, dummy. Speak. Why don't you speak?
Scared.
Makes a noise for a rich